हेलो चिल्ड्रेन, ओके चिल्ड्रेन, इन विच स्टैंडर्ड यू आर? कैन यू टेल मी? येस, यू आर इन स्टैंडर्ड 4. इन वॉट अदर वे यू कैन राइट दिस नंबर 4 चिल्ड्रेन? यू कैन राइट इट लाइक दिस एंड यू कैन राइट इट लाइक दिस एज वेल, इजंट इट? वॉट इज इट? दिस इज रोमन न्यूमरल, इजंट इट? So today we are going to discuss about chapter number 2, that is Roman numerals. Okay, so let's start with it. So children, Roman numeral system, it was developed by ancient Romans. Okay, and it is based on 7 letters of the alphabet, that is I, V, X, L, C, D and M. Where each of these letters, they represent a different value. That is, I stands for 1, V stands for 5, X stands for 10, L stands for 50, C stands for 100, D stands for 500 and M stands for 1000. Okay, these are the 7 letters which represent the Roman numeral and they all of them have different values. Okay, so you can easily remember this by remembering this sentence, that is, my dear cat loves extra vitamins intensely. There you can see the first letter, that is M, it stands for 1000. For dear, D stands for 500. For cat, C stands for 100. L stands for 50. X stands for 10, V stands for 5 and I stands for 1. You can easily remember by remembering this sentence. Okay, and these all are, you can see there, they are in descending order. So you can easily remember the values as well. Okay, so children, there are a certain rules while writing the numbers in the Roman numerals. So what are they? Let's see. We cannot repeat a symbol more than 3 times to write a Roman numeral. So let's take the example. Suppose you are in standard 4, so you cannot write it like this. 4 times I you cannot write, that is wrong. So how do you write number 4 in Roman numerals? You write it like this, isn't it? Then rule number 2 is symbols V, L and D can't be repeated at all. You cannot write number 10, you cannot write like VV, because already for this we have the symbol X which represent 10. So this is wrong. Got it? For LL, suppose L stands for 50. If you will write LL, it will give you 100. But for already we have, for representing 100, we have C. So this is wrong. We cannot repeat the symbols V, L and D at all. Got it? So to represent the large numbers, what happens? Suppose this V stands for 5, but if we'll put a bar just above that base numeral, it will represent the number which is that is number 5. It is represent 5, so bar will represent 5000. It shows the multiplication by 1000. Got it? X, which stands for 10, if we'll put a bar above that, it will represent 10,000. Got it? Similarly, if we'll put a bar above L, it will represent 50,000. If we'll put a bar above C, it will represent 100,000. D bar, it will represent 500,000. And M bar, it will represent 1 million. Okay? So, this was. Now let's see children, how to convert Roman numerals to Hindi Arabic numerals. So let's take the first example. What is this number children? It's been written 4. So here you can see this I represents 1, whereas this V represents 5. So when the smaller number is to the left of the greater value, then what do? We subtract the smaller value from the larger value. So 5 minus 1, it gives 4. It means this I, V, it will represent number 4. In the same way, let's take the example of number 9 here. I, X. So again, this I represents 1, whereas this X represents 10. Again, you can see the smaller value is there just before the greater value. So again, what we will do? We will subtract the smaller value, smaller number from the greater number. So 10 minus 1, 9. It means this IX, this represents number 9. Got it? Now, one more example, you can see here, XL. There, X represents 10, whereas L represents 50. So, again, you can see the smaller value is just before the, it is to the left of the greater value. So, again, what we will do? We will subtract 10 from 50, and what will be the answer? 40. It means this XL, it represents number 40. Got it? But on the other hand, suppose the greater value is just before and the smaller value is just after that. In that case, we add the values. This V represents 5, whereas this I represents 1. So 5 plus 1, it will be 6. So this VI, it will represent number 6. Understand? Again, if it is, suppose it is XI, one more I. Okay? So there also you can see this X represents 10, whereas this I, it represent 1, and this I also represent 1. So this XII will represent number 12. Got it? So these are the few things that you have to remember while converting the Roman numerals to Hindu Arabic numerals. Okay? Now these are the Roman numerals from number 1 to 50. Just see 1, 2, 3, 4, how we have written in Roman, and just below that we have written in Hindu Arabic system also. Okay? So this is from 1 till 50, I to L, and then we have from 51 to 100. Got it? This you have to see and you have to write it as well, okay, in your notebook. Now, let's see the questions from the textbook. So, in this chapter, we have let's reevaluate. So, the first question number 1 is convert the following to Roman numerals. So, let's start solving. Number 1 is where number A is 15. You have to write number 15 into, you have to write number 15 into Roman numerals. So first we will break it, or first we will write it in the expanded form. So this will be 10 plus 5. So how do we write 10? How do we represent 10? We represent it by the symbol X. And how do we write 5? We write it by writing V. So 15 will be represented like XV. Got it? Now let's move to question number B. 49. First we will write 49 in the expanded form. How we can write? 40 plus 9, isn't it? Then how do we write 40? We write it XL, okay, plus 9. How do we write 9? Like this. Okay? Now together we will write them to represent number 49. So it will be XLIX. Got it? So this will represent number 49. Understand? Now let's move to the next question, where you have to represent 103 into Roman numeral. So first let's write 103 in expanded form. How we will write 100 plus 3. So how do we represent 100 in Roman numeral, children? Yes, we write C for that. So C plus, how we will write 3 in Roman numerals? 3 times we will write I, isn't it? So how 103 will be represented? We have to write C, I. Got it? Now let's move to question number D, where we have to write 305 into Roman numeral. So 305. So first let's write it in the expanded form. So how we'll write expanded form? 300 plus 5. Now how we'll write 300? 3 times we have to write C, because single C represents 100. So for writing 300, we have to write C, C, C thrice, isn't it? And then 5. How do we write 5 in Roman numeral, children? V. So 305 will be written as C, 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 V. Okay? Now let's move to question number E, where we have to write 228. So first let's write 228 in expanded form. So this will be 200 plus 20 plus 8. Now how we will write 200? We have to write CC twice, isn't it? Then 20, XX, because single X represents 10. So 20 will be written as XX, and then how we will write 8? 5, 8. Okay, now we'll write them together. How we'll write them together? C, C, X, X, and this will be 8. So this will represent number 228. Okay, now let's move to the next one, where we have to represent 450. Now 450, first we will write it in the expanded form. So this will be 400 plus 5050. Now how we will write 400? We will write 400 as C, and there we have to write D. This is the way we write 400. Okay, this C will be deducted from, this will be subtracted from, the value of C will be subtracted from D, that is 500. So 500 minus 100, it will give 400. And then how do we represent 50? L. Okay, so together now we will write. So this will be C, D, L, which will represent number 450. Okay, now let's move to question number 2, where you have to convert the Roman numerals to Hindu Arabic numbers. So the first one is X, I, V. So first we'll break them and we'll write it like X. This is made up of X plus this I, V. So this X represents 10, whereas this represents 4. So 10 plus 4, how much? 14. Understand? So this represents number 14. Understand? Now let's move to the next one. L, X, I, I. So this is made up of L plus X plus I is twice. So let's write it like this. So this L represents 50, whereas X represents 10, and this II, it represents 2. So this will be 50 plus 10, 60, 60 plus 2, 62. Okay? Now, let's move to the next one. This is XCVIII. So this X represents XC. First we will see this X is just before the greater number. So what we will do? We will subtract it from 100. So let's write it like this. 100 minus 10. We will put it under the bracket. Then 5, 6, 7, 8. Isn't it? So this is 90. And this is, how much is this? How much this will represent? 8. So 90 plus 8, it will represent 98. Okay, now let's move to the next one. This is C, 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 X, 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 I. So this C, one single C represents 100. So three C, they will represent 300. So first let's break them and write C, C, C plus X, X, X plus I. So this will represent 300. whereas this will represent 30, because single x it represents 10, so 3x they will represent 30 plus 1. So how much we'll get? 331. Got it? Now let's move to the next one, C, D, V. Now there children also, first we'll break them. So this will be C, D plus V. So this C, D, how much it will represent? Because this C represents 100 and D represents 500. So what we will do? We will subtract this 100 from 500. Theek hai? So this will be 100 and then we'll write the value of V which represents 5. So 500 minus 100, it will give you 400 plus 5, and when we'll add 5 to it, we will get 405. Got it? Now let's move to the next one, which is C, M, L, X, X, V, I. So this C, M, first we will write this C and M, then plus L plus X, X plus 6. Okay? Now this C, M. M stands for 1000, whereas C stands for 100. The smaller value is before. So what do we do in this case? We'll subtract it from the larger value. So 100 minus 1000 minus 100 plus, this will be L stands for 50, then plus XX, it will represent 20, whereas VI will represent 6. So this will do here. 1000 minus 100, it will give you 900 plus 50 plus 20 plus 6. So how much you will get? 976. So this will be the answer for this given question. Okay? Now we have done the exercise questions. Now this is a challenge for you. You have to write 999 in Roman numeral. So first I have written here, first we have written it in the expanded form. So 900. Now how will write 900 in Roman numeral, children? So for writing 900, we have to write it like C, M, isn't it? Because in this case, what will happen? 1000, we will subtract 100 from 1000, then we will get this 900, isn't it? Then how will write 90? For writing 90, we have to write it X, C, because from 100 we will subtract 10 to get 90. And then how will write 9? We will write it like this, isn't it? So now we'll write them together. So it will be C, M, X, C, I, X. Okay? So this will be the number in Roman numeral. 999 will be written like this. Got it? You can practice for more numbers like this. Okay? So children, that's all for today. Rest we'll discuss in the next class. Till then, thank you. Bye.